राका चंद्र समान न रामा, पितृवाक्याश्रित कानन रामा। नाम रामायण, ए कंटिन्यूइंग डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ लॉर्ड राम्स पास टाइम्स इन द अयोध्या कांड, व्हेन इज इन अयोध्या। सो राका चंद्र समान न आनन इज फेस, समा इज लाइक, चंद्र इज द मून, राका इज ऑन अ डार्क नाइट। राका चंद्र समान न रामा, एक्चुअली लॉर्ड राम्स फेस वॉज वेरी ब्यूटिफुल, इट इज इल्यूमिनेटिंग। That just as when in a dark night, when the bright moon comes, it illumines everything. It illumines the whole night sky, and its illumination is not just in terms of the light, but it's also in terms of pleasantness, in terms of being very soothing. And when the sun is in its full blaze, it also illumines, but it's not very comforting. It's scalding often, scorching, but in contrast to the scorching sun, the moon's warmth is illumination and warmth are soothing. So the Lord's face is described is like that. Raka Chandra Samanana Rama Anana, his face. A great poet, a devotee poet, has described about Lord Ram's face. He said, Lord Ram's face is as beautiful as Lord Ram's face. He looks around the world and he tries to find some metaphor to describe Lord Ram's face beauty, and then he finds that no metaphor is adequate, and therefore he says it's comparable only with itself. It's not comparable with anything else. Of course, the poets do use, the devotees do use metaphors to describe the Lord's beauty, because by those metaphors we at least get some idea. Otherwise, if there are only self-referential descriptions, then those who cannot refer to, those who have no experience of the experience of what is being described, those of all, like all of us, who have not experienced the Lord's beauty, we will not be able to get any inkling of that beauty. So that's why many times different metaphors, like here, a moon on a night, that metaphor is used to describe the Lord's face. In the Lalita Madhava, Rupa Goswami describes that the kings who had been imprisoned, by Jarasandha, and they were released, those kings and other kings also, when they glorify Krishna, they say that actually, you know, earlier we glorified you as with choice metaphors, and we thought we were glorifying you very much, very appropriately. But now that you have bestowed your mercy on us, and we have seen your potency, we have seen your glory, then we understand that actually what we offered you as praises were actually insults. Because your all attractiveness is so great that to disglorify you with metaphors of this world is like describing the emperor of the world as a landlord in a village. The glorification becomes a denigration. And yet, although the glorification is inadequate, still that glorification is offered because because we want to express our devotion to the Lord. So there are two things. The great devotees who have had experience of Krishna, they want to communicate to us their experience of the Lord. Be it Krishna, Ram or Vishnu. They want to communicate that experience to us, and that's why they use metaphors. Although they know that the metaphors only inadequately and imperfectly describe the intensity of the experience of God. So for them, they use it to give us some idea of that experience. And we so also may use some metaphors to describe the Lord's beauty, and the purpose of that is to use our intelligence, to use our creativity in devotional service, to express whatever devotion we have, to express our desire to glorify the Lord by the metaphors that we can summon with the best of our understanding according to scripture. So, Pitruvakyashita Kanana Rama. So, that Lord who was a soothing moon, on all night, that Lord remained soothing and comforting even when he was faced with injustice and atrocity and calamity. What was that? Because of the scheming of Kaikeyi and because of no fault of his, Lord Ram was exiled, sent to the forest. Exile is a very brutal punishment. It is given for the worst of criminals. Normal criminals are maybe fined. Some more severe criminals are jailed. Some may be jailed for life. And worse than life imprisonment is banishment. And only punishment that is higher than banishment is execution. Hanging, killing, gullitoning, whatever it may be. Whichever way the killing might come about. So it's a very severe punishment. And Lord Ram had done nothing wrong to deserve it. But just because his father instructed it, so Lord Ram accepted it to keep to honor his father's words. Pitruvakya Ashrita Kanana Rama. So Kanana, so there is a poetic rhyme over here. Anana means face, Kanana means forest. So Ashrita Kanana. He took shelter in the forest. Now that Lord is the shelter of the whole world. He is the shelter of the goddess of fortune. And even the best of palaces are not, best of this world's palaces are not worthy of him. Because he is so great. And yet that Lord took shelter in the forest. That is how he demonstrated his utter selflessness and sacrifice in order to do his duty as an obedient son and demonstrate how an ideal human being should act in this world. So that Lord Ram, who is all attractive, who is all glorious, that Ram who descends in this world, he teaches thus to us, and we can understand the depth of love that is there between him and his devotees and the exalted nature of his character by which he can practice dharma even at great personal cost to himself. Such is the Lord who is filled with virtue, who remains calm and composed and dignified and compassionate even amidst great atrocity and calamity. And if we can take shelter of him, then we can also face life's ups and downs with dignity, rather than being tossed by life's ups and downs. By remembering him, we will be inspired by his example and by his potency. And thus we will be able to take shelter of him. And we will be able to stay stable in whatever situation we are. Externally we may be buffeted, but internally we will be buffered. We will be sheltered by the presence of the Lord, by the remembrance of the Lord. And thus we can grow through life's inevitable ups and downs and march towards the Lord's eternal abode, which is ultimately free from worldly ups and downs. And that process of taking shelter of him, that progress on the journey towards him, all that happens through our calling out to him, through our remembering him, through our loving him, and through our serving him. And that is the opportunity which we have whenever we practice bhakti. Thank you.